beautiful people. In today's video, I'm going to try to create a neon light effect to MaxFrost photo of Adobe stocks in Photoshop 2021. First, open the photo in Photoshop. Click the brush tool and set the foreground color to white. You can adjust the size of the brush depends on your preference. Make sure the opacity and flow are 100%. Then, highlight layer 0 and create a new layer by clicking the box with a plus sign under the layers panel, which is located on the bottom right side. Click the pen tool to create a rectangle shape, or you can choose a different shape of your preference. Then, draw it on the area of the photo you want to appear. Then, right-click and select Stroke Path. Under Tool Arrow Down option, you have to select Brush and click OK. Now, you can see the shape we created has a white stroke. You can scale or transform the rectangle by pressing Ctrl-T in Windows or Command-T in Mac. Double-click the Layer 1 in order for you to redirect to Layer Style. First, click Color Overlay and change the blend mode to white color and the opacity is 100%. Click Inner Glow, then change the blend mode to normal and the opacity is 100%. The color is white. Make sure the source is centered and adjust the size to 250 pixels. The contour is like an arc shape that you've seen on the screen and the range is 50%. After, let's add outer glow. Change the blend mode to linear dodge, opacity is 40%, and set the color to neon that you've selected. Then, set the size to 60 pixels under elements, and the range is 50%. Because we cannot add another outer glow, we will add a drop shadow in our layer. We have to set the blend mode to linear dodge. The opacity is 100% and the size set it to 250 pixels. If the figure is not applicable to you or it shows a different result, then you can adjust it according to your photo. As I said, don't be afraid to do a trial and error. This time, we have to add a reflection to our shape. To achieve it, we have to set our brush and set the size of the brush to 500 to 1000 pixels and trace the rectangle shape using the pen tool. Add another layer, then right-click and select Stroke Path. Select a brush tool under Drop Arrow option and click OK. Change the blend mode from normal to linear dodge and set the fill to 20%. Group the layer 1 and 2 by pressing Ctrl-G in Windows or Command-G in Mac and rename it to Neon. Highlight layer 0 and select the subject or model using selection tools you are comfortable with. In my case, I already do the selection and I saved it. That's why I just need to click the select tool and click the load selection. After you are done with the selection, highlight the neon layer and click the mask. You can see the neon shape is at the front of the model. To bring it to the back, press Ctrl-I in Windows or Command-I in Mac to invert it. Click the brush tool and set the foreground color to white and adjust the size of your brush too. Then start to use the brush to reveal the shape. Now we have to add the hue and saturation adjustment layer. Make sure you click the colors option under the hue and saturation property. You can slide the hue and saturation to the color you like. This time, right-click the Hue and Saturation and select Blending option. To break this slider, under Blend with this layer, hold Option and click this slider. Then, you can adjust the blending separately and click OK. To put some neon light next to the shape of their head, you can add another layer and change the blending from normal to linear dodge and change the opacity to 7%. The last part is optional. I added some smoke effect to the photo using brush tool. To do this, select layer 0 and add new layer. You can download smoke brushes in brusheasy.com for free. This is the before photo. This is after photo with neon light effect. Hope this short video is useful to you and please support our channel by subscribing to it. If you have some clarifications and subject you want me to tackle, please leave your comment below. Thank you. If you have knowledge, let others light their candles at it. Have a blessed Sunday, everyone.